Joining us on the line is Energy Secretary Jericho Petilia. Secretary Petilia, good morning, sir.
Good morning, Pinky.
All right, Secretary, any more updates on what happened yesterday? We understand, of course, from your interview this morning and even yesterday, I know you had 3,000 phone calls and 2,000 text messages, you were saying. Just to do a recap on that, Secretary, one power plant tripped and that cascaded into six other plants. Is that correct, sir?
Well, technically, that's what happened. Okay. Although the I wouldn't put fault on the plant because the tripping might have been caused also by the transmission lines.
Yes.
So we're trying to find out which one is which, because when I saw the log last night when we had a meeting, they went down simultaneously. So you can't really say which one went first at this point.
Okay, but this kind of massive blackout, Secretary, this much energy taken, removed, or you know, causing this much blackout in the country, sir, I understand this was unprecedented.
The first time this happened, or the last time this happened, was way back. I can't even remember. Even the DOE officials that I've discussed this with, okay, could not even remember when this has happened. So this is more of a one-off thing more than something that happens every now and then.
Mm-hmm. When we talk about this, sir, I mean, looking at it a couple of days before elections, is it somehow good that it happened, you know, a couple of days before elections? Because this is something you didn't expect that would actually happen.
No, we didn't expect this to happen. But what we also did was, in preparation for election, okay, we actually asked everybody, all concerned in the power sector, to really prepare for this, do the maintenance, okay, before or after the election, okay, try to see, okay, what can be done. I've heard the interviews earlier with Meralco that they're looking at their transformers, trying to make sure that they're in place, no loose lines, and you know, everybody's doing everything they can at this point.
Mm-hmm.
And perhaps, okay, what we're looking at is because Kalaka, as I understand in the meeting last night, actually had double checking of their plants, the switches and just about everything, just to make sure that nothing happens on election day. And I'm just, these are all speculation until such time that we get real information from NGCP based on their analysis. But over-preparing can also be a reason here.
Seriously, sir?
Maybe they... hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. During the maintenance, okay, they may have over-prepared, and I don't know. We're still trying to find out, because they were actually doing some checks on their plants, okay, a few days before this actually happened. So we're looking at all angles right now, okay, but we're trying to make sure that this doesn't happen on election day.
I can understand, Secretary, it's hard to give a conclusion, especially investigation is still ongoing. Again, as you said, these are speculations on why yesterday actually happened. But I just wanted to ask you, because this plant, for example, was too checked, it was overchecked, that could possibly mm-hmm. pose a problem to any plant, Secretary?
This is what's happening right now, okay? The plant, actually, I just got a text message right now that they want to go online, because since last night, the plant that went down, the first plant that went down, Kalaka, is actually ready to give power. They've been wanting to go online. So I told them, check the plant, and they're confident that there's nothing wrong with the plant. And then we checked the line as well. The line, NGCP has done aerial patrol, foot patrol. We've actually isolated the lines where it started, and this is the Binyan Kalaka line. They've double checked that. Everything seems to be working fine. It's good to go. We have the confidence of both parties that they're good to go. But I'm telling everybody, both parties, one more check, please.
Not yet.
Okay.
Yeah. Not
okay,
just
not
yet.
Not yet.
Because it can possibly
yet.
Trip again, Secretary, right? I mean, you want to make sure everything is well and good before it goes online, meaning it services electricity again.
That's right. But at this point, they're really confident that they can go online and it won't cause any problem. All the auto protection are working. It's all there. But I'm telling them, okay, give it one more try, one more run. And I want an explanation on why it happened.
Yeah.
Because if you don't, you know, for all I care, they can turn it on now. It will be running for 20 years without any problem. But without any explanation on what happened yesterday, I won't be able to sleep.
Yes, I understand that, Secretary. But it's isolated. Is the investigation isolated on the Kalaka plant?
Because it's isolated, that's not on.
Go ahead, Secretary.
It's not only isolated on the Kalaka plant. It's actually isolated on the circuit around the Kalaka, including the Kalaka Binyan lines and Santa Rosa, for that matter.
Yeah. Okay. The circuit around Kalaka, but Kalaka is a power plant, sir. So, but that's the first one that tripped.
That's right.
But
that's the first one that tripped.
Okay, Secretary, help us understand the situation. And if a power plant actually trips, there is supposed to be, how I understand it, sir, and I'm sorry, it's a little bit technical for me, it should be able to shut off automatically and
that's
not
right.
affect the other power plants. Now, the question is, why was there a domino effect? Why was there a cascading of the power plant shutting down?
Okay, the auto protection, the technical term for that is the auto protection system is supposed to be in place. That's what we're looking at right now. These switches that are actually, the switches are actually within the premise of Kalaka, but this is actually owned by NGCP. Okay, in fact, there are people right now from NGCP and Transco looking at those areas. Okay, and for some reason, that didn't kick in. That's why it affected the entire grid. So we're still trying to find out what really happened at this point. Because, you know, if that was a transformer that blew up, it's easy to replace and it's easy to isolate. If that was a tower that went down because of a typhoon, for example, that's easy to manage. If it's a line that was hit by a tree, falling tree, we can do that.
Well.
But these are switches. And the only way we can find out the technical problems is to get all the logs of the power plants that were affected and around the area, including the NGCP log, and then put them all together. And I'm confident we can find the area where we can isolate the problem.
Who is heading the investigation? Is it the NGCP, sir?
NGCP, and then I've asked Transco to get involved as well.
Okay, so I guess the most important, really, Secretary, is to get the logs. There are two things, I think, at least in my mind, sir, that are obvious. One, power plant shutdown. That's the circuit around the Kalaka power plant. And number two, you were saying that initial investigation showed the cables are actually okay. But this is the point, sir. Apart from Kalaka or the circuit around Kalaka shutting down, sir, the second point that needs to be addressed is, why did the auto protection system not work?
That's right.
Okay.
Why didn't it kick in?
Okay. All right. Malalaman niyo po ito, Secretary, through the log you were saying.
That's right. And I hope to get an update from NGCP before the end of the day.
Okay. If you get an update, sir, I guess hopefully you're hoping that you'd probably have some sort of explanation within the day.
Yes, okay. The explanation will help us understand and make sure we anticipate any happenings in the future, especially on Election Day, but not only on Election Day, in all future days. But at this point, Pinky, I'd like to assure the public that NGCP and the Kalaka Power Plant, they're actually eager to get back online. They're ready to go back.
Yeah.
They've checked. Nothing will happen. But okay, I just need an explanation at this point.
Understandably, sir. The plant is okay, the transmission lines seem okay, but you still want to find out first and foremost what happened here, and you want them to do another run before they actually go online. Secretary, of course, I need to bring this up again. Mindanao already has insufficient power supply on regular days. You have a contingency for a massive blackout that may occur, like the one that happened here in Luzon.
Okay, we're talking about Mindanao now,
yes,
the situation in Mindanao. In Mindanao, okay, honestly, Pinky, okay, most people panic when we have power failures in Luzon because we're not used to it. In Mindanao,
it's a
daily routine for some, so they already know what to do. They have flashlights, they're more than prepared. But we want a surprise on election day. And what we're going to do is we're going to target no brownout on election day itself in Mindanao. Okay, and we're confident we can do that simply because we've released water from August 4. That water was impounded since September of 2012. And then we started releasing that May in preparation for election. So we have an increased supply coming out from the hydro for the election season. Plus the fact that I appeal to all establishments if they can refrain from using their plants, their malls, the large users, and give their power to me even just for one day for this election.
Even for just May 13.
In the spirit of national interest.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, all right. Secretary Petilia, of course, we're hoping that everything turns out okay and that within the day we get an explanation. Sir, I'm sure you're anxious to get an explanation yourself on why yesterday actually happened here in Luzon.
That's right. I'm just as anxious as anybody else, and we will share the information with the public as soon as we get them.
All right. Energy Secretary Jericho Petilia, sir, thank you so much for coming on the phone.
Thank you very much. Thank you.